Hello dear students, welcome once again to our channel Maths in Minutes with Priya. Today we are going to begin with very important topic known as triangles. This is clip number 116 of this channel. Today we are going to begin with triangles, so part 1. Why this triangle topic is important? Because there are variety of problems and variety of concepts, theorems and formulas. Now, by hearting everything and remembering everything, one might get overwhelmed. But if you understand the basics, so in every part, I'm going to go with a different concept, and on same concept, I'll solve the examples so that you will easily remember the formula and concept. Today, we are going to learn centroid, something about centroid. Now, what is a centroid? Its meaning, its properties, and how those properties are used in exams. That we are going to see today. So let's begin. The meeting point of all medians of a triangle is known as centroid. But what is a median? First, let us understand what is a median. A median joins vertex and midpoint of opposite side. So if I talk about this acute angle triangle means all three angles are acute, less than 90 degree. Acute means less than 90 degree. All three angles are acute angles, and hence this is known as acute angle triangle. Now if I talk about this, they are saying median means joining vertex and midpoint of opposite side. So take vertex A, midpoint of opposite side, that is BC, this is the midpoint. When I join them, it becomes a median. Can you see now this line? This is a median. When I join vertex C to midpoint of opposite side, this becomes a median. When I join vertex B with midpoint of opposite side, this also becomes a median. Now here, this is acute angle triangle. This I have drawn as right angle triangle. Right angle triangle means one angle is right angle. This is 90. So remaining two will naturally be acute angles, because some of the angles is 180. If this is 90, their total is going to be 90. So naturally both are acute. This is known as right angle triangle. And this is obtuse angle triangle. Can you see this angle? One angle will be greater than 90 degree and other two will be naturally less than 90 degree. So this becomes acute angle triangle. In all these triangles, we can draw medians. So here I have marked the midpoints, and now I am going to join midpoint and the opposite side. Opposite vertex. Midpoint of any side and opposite vertex. So can you see all these three triangles? In all three triangles, these medians, they are intersecting in one single point. Can you see this? One point. This particular point is known as centroid. Now let's concentrate on properties of centroid. When you understand these properties, then solving the examples become a 1 second or 2 second thing. Let's see what are the properties. I have drawn a triangle here, ABC. D, E, F are midpoints of sides, and I have joined these midpoints to vertex. So G becomes a centroid because it's a meeting point of all medians, right? Now the very important property. If I consider median AD, then AG upon GD is equal to 2:1. That means this AG part is twice of this GD part. Are you getting it? So towards vertex, now in this median, particular median, this part is towards vertex and this part is towards this side, towards this base, right? So this, the part near vertex is 2 and opposite part is 1. 2:1. Now if I talk about median BE, which part is towards vertex? BG is towards vertex, so this will be 2 and this will be 1. So BG upon G is 2 upon 1. If I talk about median FC or CF, then this part towards vertex CG upon GF, it will be 2:1. Are you getting it? So what type of examples you can get based on this property? They may give you something like this. In triangle ABC, G is the centroid. GE, this part is given to you, 3 cm. Find length BE. This is the question. This part is given to you and you are asked length of BE. Now how can we find it? For that you must know, when G is centroid, BE is the median. And if BE is the median, then BG upon GE is going to be 2:1. Ye pata hona chahiye. Getting it? So I can just substitute here. BG upon GE mujhe pata hai 2:1. GE is 3, that is given to me. And I need to find BG. So BG upon GE is BG upon 3, because 3 cm is given to me. So when I solve, I get BG as 6 cm. BG will be 6. See, GE is 3 and BG is double of that. So this is 6. Now I need to find BE. So 6 plus 3, that is 9. That will be your answer. Now, this you must solve in half second. GE is given to you, so BE will be 3 times of it. Correct? This is 1 part and this is 2 part. So, totally there are 3 parts. So, if this is 3 cm, this will be, whole will be 9 cm. ये half second में आ जाना चाहिए, उससे ज़्यादा time नहीं लगना चाहिए, when you know this properties. Now using same property, suppose you are given length AD, like they say that ABC is a triangle and G is the centroid, ऐसा दिया हुआ है. Then they say AD is 12 cm, find GD. So this 12 cm is divided how? It is divided in the parts 2:1. Correct? 12 is how is divided 2:1, because G is centroid, AD is median, that means this has to be 2:1. Ye dimag mein fit baith jana chahiye. If this is 2 and this is 1, now we have to find GD. So how do we find? Ye ratio proportion ke jaisa hi hai. 12 is divided in the ratio 2:1 and we need to find 1. So 12 into 1 upon 3. 2 plus 1 is 3. So what is GD? 1 upon 3. AG will be 2 upon 3. So GD is 4 cm. AG is 8 cm. This part is twice of this part. Ye to humko pata hai na? So this is 8 and this is 4. Total is 12. Got my point? One more important property about area. When you know that GE is centroid, then area of triangle ABG, area of triangle AGC and area of triangle BGC, they are equal. These three areas are equal. And the three triangles milke ban jata hai triangle ABC. That means these three triangles, they are 1/3. Each is 1/3 of area of triangle ABC. Got my point? Look, here I have drawn a smaller figure. Iska hi chota nikala hai. Area of this triangle AGB, AGC and BGC, they are all equal. 1/3, 1/3, 1/3 of this bigger triangle. I have written all these properties. Wo main baad mein dikhati hu. Maine pura likha hai, you can copy that. But first understand. Likhne ka jaldi nahi hai. First we will understand. यहाँ तक समझ में आया? नाउ कॉन्सेंट्रेट ऑन दिस ट्रायंगल बी जी सी, इसको कॉन्सेंट्रेट करो, ये छोटा ट्रायंगल। हियर वी नो दैट डी इज द मिड पॉइंट, सो इन दिस ट्रायंगल बी जी सी दिस वर्टेक्स एंड मिड पॉइंट दे आर जॉइंट, सो दिस ट्रायंगल एंड दिस ट्रायंगल दे विल बी हाफ हाफ ऑफ ट्रायंगल बी जी सी, सो एरिया ऑफ ट्रायंगल बी डी जी एंड एरिया ऑफ ट्रायंगल डी जी सी दे विल बी इक्वल एंड दे विल बी हाफ ऑफ एरिया ऑफ ट्रायंगल बी जी सी। समझ में आ रहा है? सिमिलरली यहाँ पर भी दीज टू विल बी इक्वल एंड दे विल बी हाफ ऑफ एरिया ऑफ ट्रायंगल ए बी जी। सिमिलरली हियर दिस ट्रायंगल ए जी ई and GEC, their areas will be equal and each of them will be half of area of triangle AGC. यहाँ तक clear है? Now again concentrate on this particular triangle BGC. We just learned that area of triangle BGC, it is 1/3 of this whole triangle, right? But this BGC is divided into these two triangles. So this BGD is half of BGC. That means this particular is 1/6 of ABC. ये 1/3 है और उसका ये half है. So half into 1/3, that is 1/6 of ABC. That means this every small triangle 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, their all areas are equal and they are 1/6 of this big triangle. So ye areas 1, 2, 3, these three triangles are 1/3 of big triangle. And jab main usko bhi aur chota kar deti hu is tarah, so this small, they are 1/6 of bigger triangle. Now what type of examples you will get here? They may say that area of triangle ABC is say 90 square centimeter. What is area of triangle BGC if G is centroid? You can immediately say 1/3 of 90, that is 30 degree. If they ask you what is area of triangle BGD, it will be 1/6 of 90 degree, you can immediately say this is 15 degree. Getting it? Which type of examples come on area? जब तुमको centroid का property पता है, मतलब ऐसा तुमको एक triangle दे दिया, इसको G बोल दिया, G is centroid, ये ABC है, and they tell you area of this big triangle ABC is 90 degree. What is area of this triangle? You can say 1/6 of ABC. So you can say it is 15 square centimeter. I hope you understood this. Now I have written these properties. Now let's see those properties. You can copy these properties in your notebook if you want. I have explained everything, so I'm not going to explain again. ये तुमको चाहिए तो तुम copy कर लो. Area of triangle AGB is equal to area of triangle BGC is equal to area of triangle AGC. Triangle ABC is divided into three triangles of equal areas, 1/3 of ABC, सब कुछ हमने अभी देखा. And this example also I just explained to you, 90 का 1/3 किया 30. And now small triangles BGD, DGC, they are half of BGC, so 1/6 of big triangle. ये सब कुछ अभी मैंने explain किया, you can copy it in your notes. Now let's see one more property. Here I have drawn triangle ABC, D is midpoint of BC, E is midpoint of AC, G is centroid. If I join this centroid and a midpoint, and then I join these two midpoints to each other, then area of this triangle is 1/12 of this whole triangle. This type of examples do come in exam, but you should know that this area is 1/12 of whole triangle. What is this small triangle? Concentrate again. What is G? G is centroid. D and E are midpoints of BC and AC. I have joined these midpoints together and now they are joined to centroid. So this triangle is formed and this one is 1/12 of ABC. So what type of examples you can get? They may give you in this figure, they will mark these two as equal sides, these two as equal sides. So you should understand that D and E are midpoints and they are joined. In triangle ABCG is centroid, area of whole triangle is given to you, that is 108 square centimeter. Find area of triangle DGE. So straight away you can say it's 1/12 of 108, that is 9 square centimeter. Again in half second you should get this answer. Where will be the other triangles? In same manner we can form. Suppose this is the midpoint. So what are they saying? You first join these midpoints together. Isko isse join kiya, isko bhi isse. Then this triangle formed is 1/12 of this whole triangle. Samajh mein aa raha hai concept? So today we understood what is centroid, what are its properties and how we apply those properties in examples and save our valuable time. In next part we are going to understand about in circle, in center and properties of angle bisector. If you haven't yet subscribed to our channel Maths in Minutes with Priya, please do so. It's absolutely free. So see you in the next part. In every part of triangle we are going to cover different properties and formula. लेकिन एक बार examples में apply करोगे तो वो याद रह जाता है. It's not at all difficult. So see you in the next part. Till then stay happy, stay blessed. Bye for today.